OpenAI has launched a new feature in ChatGPT called Deep Research. So first, let me explain you what this deep research is all about in simplest of terms. So imagine you are a research scientist or a research student and you want to get some information about a specific topic for your research. And usually you just go to Google and type, I want this particular topic, and then just go into some old research papers. Then you just copy paste or compress and read the contents from it. This is exactly what deep research does, but in a much more efficient way. So it basically searches the web and finds 20 plus sources, then slowly compresses and summarizes all the sources where it has got the information and gives it in the response. The cool thing about this is that it literally takes 15 to 30 minutes for its research to complete. So once you gave the prompt, it will give you the response only after 20 to 30 minutes. So it's basically like web searching with a reasoning model. And the great thing about this is that it uses a fine-tuned version of OpenAI's upcoming O3 model. And if you scroll down over here, as you can see here, deep research may take anywhere between 5 to 30 minutes to complete its work. And this is the accuracy metric that they have given on humanities last exam, which is just an evaluation based on expert level questions. And the accuracy in deep research is about 25.3%. Whereas the most famous DeepSeek's R1 model has accuracy of 9.4. So imagine it being 2.5 times better than DeepSeek's R1. And it has also its own limitation. Especially they have given here sometimes hallucinate facts in the response or make incorrect inferences. That obviously meant to happen because it's going to take like 15 to 20 minutes to give us a response. So there are high chances it's going to hallucinate. And they have also said these issues, if they have any, will be fixed and improved. And next thing is the access. So this is going to get rolled out for the pro users with 100 queries per month. And the plus and teams users will get access next. And the free users aren't going to get this feature. So now let's see what they have showcased in the demo video. So this is going to be the interface, and we will be having an option called as deep research. So if we enable that, it's going to, like, you know, surf the web for a longer time and get us the response. So this was a sample prompt given, basically the differences between Android and iOS adoptions across various markets, and give some metrics based on the topic. After you give that, deep research will ask you some questions for your confirmation. Kind of similar to the AI agent operator, because after your answer, it's going to do research for 15 to 30 minutes. So it just wants to verify with you a second time so that it doesn't, you know, bring up some bad responses. And once you fill up all the necessary details like this, then the research gets started. So this is a thing that takes like 15 to 30 minutes, and it will go basically from one website to another finding the information. And to the right, you'll be having what exactly it does, which website it's visiting, and the data which is fetched from that particular website. So here you can see it has literally searched like this, searched for survey on language learning by country. It's basically performing web searches. Then it just gets the websites in from those web searches and then compresses and reasons that content. So as you can see here, it has used Wikipedia over here. And you're also having this progress bar. So once it is done, you will be getting the response. And this is how the response looks. It's like just a long paragraph with heading and some tables and metrics. So I assume this feature will be extremely useful for people who do high level research and who are in need of going through tons of research papers online. So those people will really find this tool useful. And I hope you'd have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.